Hello everyone, welcome back to illphocorphics. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to design professional text effects in Photoshop. This will a professional text effect tutorial where I will show you that what you need to do to create this text effect. And after creating the text effects, I will also show you how to use this PSD and use it as a mockup. So if you want to learn this trick, watch carefully until the end of this tutorial. Because this is full of trick and tips tutorials, and I hope you will enjoy to learn something new. And if you like my tutorial, and want to support my channel, you can join to my channel. I have launched channel membership for my viewer and subscribers. Channel membership will help me and my channel to make awesome tutorials for you. So support my channel if you like. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Not just subscribe, also press the bell icon so that you might never miss any chance to learn new things about Photoshop. So be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. Let's start today's tutorial. Now we are here in the magical world of Photoshop. I have already created a document for you to show the effect. You can go with any size of document as you want. Now let's start to create the text effect. We will start by making our background. So go to the adjustment layer, and take gradient. Now click to the gradient. Change to a blue gradient. Then adjust the gradient. Choose a blue and deep blue gradient. After that, increase the scale of the gradient. Again, adjust the gradient properly. Hit OK. Next, we will use some patterns in the background. Go to the adjustments layer. And take the pattern. Now take a pattern from the bottom. I have already created a pattern. Then scale the pattern a little bit better. And position it. If you like, you can download all the halftone patterns. After that, change the blending mode into soft light. And bring down the fill of the pattern. Then again go to the adjustments layer. And take pattern. Use this pattern. Hit OK. Take the pattern to the back. Then change the blending mode into soft light. And decrease the fill around 5%. Then press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer, then double click on the pattern layer. Then change the angle to 180 degrees. Hit OK. Then select all the layers. And press Ctrl or Command plus G to make a group. Then change the name of the group into the background. Now we are done with the background. Next we will start to create the text effect. Go to the toolbar, and take the type tool. Click to the middle. Type a name that you want. Go to the character. If you don't find it here, go to Windows, and take the character. Then change the font into Buchanan Expanded. If you like to download this font, check the link in the description. Then make the text size bigger. And adjust it in the perfect area. Hit OK. Then apply the italic style. And make the gap minus 50. Now you can see we take the text. Next, we will start applying the effect. Go to the toolbar and take a polygonal lasso tool. Then zoom closer. Then take a ruler guide and put it here. Then make a triangle selection like me. Then again press shift and make the same selection on the A character. Now zoom out. Then go to select. And inverse. Next, apply a layer mask. Now you will see it cut off. Take the move tool. Delete the ruler. Then convert the text layer into a smart object. Next, we will start by giving the effect look. First press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Then double-click on the copy layer. It will open the layer style option. First, apply a gradient. Then adjust the gradient like me. Follow my steps. And adjust it as you want. Then we will apply a stroke to the layer. Then choose a color for the stroke. Then hit OK. Next, we will apply a bevel and emboss. Choose style into stroke emboss. Then do some experiments with the depth, size, and soften. Then also try to adjust the opacity of the highlights. Then hit OK. After that, press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Then delete all the layer style effects. And decrease the opacity to 0%. And double click on the layer again. Then again apply a bevel and emboss. Change the style into the inner bevel. Then decrease the shadow mood opacity to 0%. And adjust the highlight mood opacity. Then increase the depth of 100%. And adjust the size a little bit. Then apply a pattern. Use this halftone pattern. Change the blending mood into overlay. After that, apply a 90% scale. Again, go to bevel and emboss and adjust the effect a little bit. After all the adjustment, hit OK. Now you can see we already created the text effect. But we need to do the background depth effect to make the text look good. Select the backdash layer. Press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Then double click on the layer, and apply color overlay. Use a deep blue color. Then copy the color code. Because we need that color in later. Then apply a stroke. Click to the color and paste the color code you copied before. Hit OK. Then use the down and right arrow key to make a shadow. Adjust it properly. Again select the bottom dash text layer. Then press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Then double click on the layer. Apply a stroke. Choose a white color. Again choose a white blue color. Then hit OK. Then open the layer style of the top layer. And apply outer glow. Adjust the outer glow effect a little bit according to the text to give some shadow. Hit OK. Now select the bottom dash copy four layers. Press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Then double click on the copy four layer. Apply the color overlay. Then change the stroke color into the deep blue color we used before. Hit OK. Take the dash layer to the top. And decrease the fill color to 0%. Then select the bottom dash copy four layers. Then press Alt or Option on your keyboard, then press down arrow key on the keyboard. It will create copy and the back depth effect to the text. After that, select all the background depth effect layer, and then press Ctrl or Command plus G to make a group. Then change the group name. Then double click on the group to open layer style. Then apply a drop shadow. Adjust the drop shadow properly according to the background. You can follow my steps to create a drop shadow. After the first adjustment, create another drop shadow. Adjust it properly again. Hit OK. After that selection, all the layers and groups, then make a final group. Give a name to the final group. Now you can see we are done. We just created the text effect properly. And you can use this text effect and use it as a mock-up. You can change the name and use it for any kind of name and it will work fine. Let me show you. Double click on the thumbnail of the first layer. It will open a new window. Take crop tool and make the canvas size bigger. Hit OK. Then change the text name into anything. I will go with IPC for my channel name. Take move tool. Then delete the layer mask of the text layer. Put it to the middle. Then save the file. Go to the main composition. And you can see we apply the same effect for another name. So if you follow this technique, you can easily create the text effect. And if you want to download the text effect, just check the link in the description. It's free to download. But if you like to support, you can also support my work by Patreon. It will help me to keep making good tutorials for you. So support me and my work. Let's see our final output. Now, I just show you how to create and design a professional text effect in Photoshop. I try to explain and show you all the things that a professional designer does to create a professional text. If you want to learn how to do that, I think this tutorial is the best for you. And I also offer you a free download for you, but if you like to support my work, you can join my channel or by Patreon. If you join my channel, it will be a big support for me to keep my channel go. So please support my work. And thank you so much for watching until the end of this tutorial. Please give a big thumbs up on the tutorial if you like and leave your comments down below. I would love to hear something from you. If you have any questions or problems, I will try to solve it. If you like, you can also check out my other Photoshop tutorials on my channel. I hope you will like and learn something new. So go and check out. Share also the tutorial with your friends and help my channel to grow. Thank you so much for today. See you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, keep learning.